this is the best way I can describe Anne. That's my goal for aging. Because she had more fun and reinvented herself in her late 50s, early 60s, after she retired and lost her retirement, I guess. I'm not exactly sure all the numbers on that, but.
Yeah, she worked for Bell South,
yeah,
I think.
For years and years.
But came down and found this family at the station inn.
Yes.
Wound up working the door
working
and throwing
door.
Out Vanderbilt football players who talked too much.
And she was what, 4'11" maybe?
She was like 3'2".
Yeah, but you know, she was amazing, and she did it all. You know, her heart was way bigger than her body. You know, and she just became such a dear friend to me. I mean, and as she was to so many people. I mean, she'd tell you what she thought. There was no holding back. But I mean, I would just look at her and go, God, that's the goal right there. They called me up. The SteelDrivers were going to be the very first band to play the Caverns, Cumberland Caverns. And they thought that was cool. And they were like, hey, can we ride down there with you? And I'm like, sure, this will be great. And then I thought, oh no, I'm going to have my daughter with me. And as you just explained with their nicknames, you can imagine what their normal banter is like. Not really appropriate for a six-year-old.
No.
So I'm thinking, oh boy, this may be rough, but we'll just see how it goes. So they get there and they've got bags of candy for her, toys. I mean, it's suddenly Aunt Anne and Aunt Lynn. And they take her the whole day, spoiler rotten, and could not have been perfect with her. I don't think I heard, you know, one single bad word slip. So that's just the way, you know, they were. And after that day, my daughter, she said, is Miss Anne in our family? Is she part of our family? And I said, she's not, but yes, she is.